To determine the correct panel size, take the circumference of the trunk at a level midway between the lowest ribs and the upper iliac crest. If a fit tool is not available, fold each belt arm equally to achieve the desired waist circumference and secure the belt ends. The universal belt is available in two belt widths, the 6-inch or 15-centimeter slim version and the 8-inch or 20-centimeter standard version. Both can be used with a variety of different lordotic or non-lordotic back panels. Ensure the belt compression system is stretched to its full width and reposition the compression system handles onto the belt arms. Ensure that correct spinal protocol is followed throughout the application. Position the belt by centering the posterior panel over the spine, with the bottom of the posterior panel approximately at the sacrococcygeal joint. Remove the overlap closures. Wrap the lumbar belt around the waist and through the Össur fit tool. Adjust the length of belt arms to position the tool centrally and secure the belt ends to desired sizing. If patient's waist exceeds 50 inches or 127 centimeters, an extension belt can be added to each belt arm to reach a maximum belt circumference of 70 inches or 178 centimeters. Remove the fit tool from the belt. Place belt ends into the overlap closures. To obtain the lowest profile fit, the belt arm ends can be trimmed if later adjustments are not required. Close the belt. Slide fingers through the holes in the two compression system handles and pull until the belt is at the appropriate tightness. If necessary, adjust the compression system cord length. If using an interior panel, select the appropriate interior panel to provide the correct level of support for your patient. The panel should be centered between the abdomen, with the bottom edge just above the symphysis pubis, while still allowing the patient to sit comfortably. The brace may require fine-tuning for comfort, fit, and stabilization when sitting, standing, or ambulating. The Miami LSO compression system also allows adjustments by detaching the belt arms from the hook and loop strip posteriorly. Trimming the belts at an angle can give the opportunity to accommodate different anatomies.